Wider View on Northern Sound with Julianne Sheridan.
And you're very welcome back to the programme this Thursday afternoon. Well, I don't know if many of you have seen it, but I have seen it. It's a gruesome video online showing the barbaric killing of a fox by a pack of dogs. Well, the Irish Council Against Blood Sports has this week called on the Minister for Agriculture, Simon Coveney, to reconsider his decision not to ban fox hunting with packs of dogs. Joining us on the line this afternoon is Aideen Urell from the Irish Council Against Blood Sports. Good afternoon to you, Aideen.
Good afternoon, Julianne.
Aideen, tell us a wee bit about this video.
Well, this video came to light. It was covered in the Sunday World. They exposed the video in the Sunday World. They had gotten it off the Facebook of a known criminal in Waterford. He put it up in his Facebook and was obviously delighted to do so. I mean, this is the most appalling cruelty to a fox. It is just beyond belief. It is something that I can hardly look at, and I've been a long time campaigning. I've been looking at some pretty horrible things, and I have to say that I found it difficult.
Yeah.
It's really the most horrible torture of a fox.
And I watched it myself. Well, part of it, I couldn't watch the end of it, but just to get a bit of research done for this interview. But
yeah,
tell, for people maybe that haven't seen it, and maybe you could be a bit PG about it, just tell us what actually happens in it.
Well, there's a group of men, obviously they don't show their face, but they're urging their dogs to bite the fox, and they're dragging it around the place. And the horrible thing is that the fox's tail, we just noticed there today, is cut off. And the fox, it's actually cut off before they do this. The guy is waving the fox around by the legs. It's just appalling. And I just don't know how anybody... I don't understand these people. There's obviously a streak of sadism going on here. It's appalling.
Just on it, Minister Coveney, what did he rule regarding fox hunting with packs of dogs? And I know when I spoke to you yesterday about this, you were talking about, I suppose, the fox hunting that does be on the Christmas cards around that time of year on horseback. There is another type of fox hunting. Isn't there lamping and stuff?
Oh, yes, there's all kinds of... The fox is very much a persecuted creature in this country. And, you know, it's persecuted out of all proportion to any damage it might do. I mean, really, the fox doesn't do the kind of damage that people are claiming. It's an old myth. I mean, they don't really take lambs. They might take the very odd one. They might take a dead one. But really and truly, it's being persecuted beyond what it should be. It's terrible. It's about time now that people looked at this scientifically. The fox really doesn't do that much. It's not a huge agricultural threat. You know, it has been proven in the UK that it's not a huge threat.
I remember a couple of years ago, maybe even before I started working here, on the Joe Finnegan show one morning, a lady came on and she was saying that she had a pet fox. Well, a fox that used to come into our garden every morning to be fed. And she came on, Joe, because she was wondering where it had gone to, that she hadn't seen it in a couple of weeks, and she'd wondering, had it been killed? And I suppose her point at the time was, you know, that foxes are considered vermin, but badgers are not.
Well, actually, they're not classified as vermin for the purposes of the Wildlife Act. The National Parks and Wildlife Service will confirm that. They're not classified as vermin. No. This is just another myth that's put out there. You know, it's to give them an excuse to go out and hunt down an animal just for their own kicks. That's what they're doing.
Have you sent your release to the minister? Because I know within that you have a link to this video.
Yes, we have. Well, I just want to point out to people that in fox hunting with hounds, although they won't be posting this on their Facebook page at the hunt, they won't be talking about it and posting it on their Facebook page. They do. There are packs of dogs, followed by mounted riders, do kill foxes. I mean, it's accounting. They talk about accounting for the fox. They set out to kill foxes, and they use a huge pack of hounds to do so. For instance, one hunting report in the Farmer's Journal about a hunt in my own county here in Westmeath said that it went out. The hunting report said that it caught a fox and chopped it. You can imagine what that means. Mm. That means it was literally torn apart. That's the hunting terminology they use, chopped and overhauled and all sorts of, and accounting for. They don't use what we'd say, ripped apart and disemboweled. They don't use those kind of words.
What is the minister, has he been very vocal on this issue?
Leanne, it's legal. They can use packs of dogs to bite foxes to death. And our country thinks that's okay. Our minister thinks that's okay, and he exempts it from prosecution in the new legislation, just as it had been done in the previous legislation. And it's banned in the UK. England, Scotland and Wales have banned fox hunting with hounds. And we're the last bastion of this barbarism, is all I can call it. And it's the reason why they don't go after these people is because so-called pillars of the community are involved in hunting.
And just on it, you're obviously getting very annoyed over this. This has been on, like this story, I suppose what I'm talking to you today is because of this video online, and I've seen it, as I said, and it just brings it all home. But you've been fighting this cause for quite a while.
Yes, we've been, the Irish Council Against Blood Sports was founded in 1966. And it was actually founded by some people, actors and people who were involved in soap operas. There was one called The Reardons, and Tom Cowley, who played Tom Reardon. You probably never heard of him, Julianne.
I can't say I did, to be honest, Aideen.
Yeah, well, everybody knew. He was on everybody's lips. Everybody knew Tom Reardon as if he was a real person, you know. He was the head of the household in The Reardons. He founded, along with other people, the Irish Council Against Blood Sports, and we've been campaigning ever since. But mind you, it did take a long time in England as well. The League Against Cruel Sports was founded in the 1920s, and it took till 2005 to ban hunting with hounds.
Yeah. So you're again today calling on the minister, and you've been in contact with his office to reconsider his decision not to ban fox hunting with packs of dogs. When is this legislation likely to come up for discussion again, or can you keep pressing it with him so that he reviews it ASAP?
Well, perhaps there'll be a private member's bill taking the talk of that.
Have you been on to your local TDs?
Well, we have a number of TDs in the Dáil who are supportive of our cause, and we have many people who might think this was disgusting, but they're not about to get involved. Do you know what I mean? They're turning a blind eye. See no evil, hear no evil, and speak no evil. It's very hard to get their attention, Julianne. They just ignore you. Mm. They just brush it under the carpet like every other social issue in this country. It's brushed under the carpet. Don't talk about it, you know. We don't see it, but this video has come up now, and they can't ignore it, because this is what the kind of thing that's going on. This is allowed. This is permitted.
Just on it, Aideen, I suppose, like, I went on to the social media site last night, and it was still on the home feed, and people are obviously shocked by it, and it's circulating. It's only going to grow in the next few weeks and highlight what has actually happened here.
Hopefully, Julianne, hopefully this will, you know, that people will get annoyed and they will wake up to this, what's going on in our beautiful little country. From the 1st of November right through to Patrick's Day, twice a week generally the hunts are out in their various counties doing this kind of thing, persecuting the wildlife. And they've got carte blanche to do it, permission of our government, and we call ourselves a civilised country.
Aideen Urell there, spokesperson at the Irish Council Against Blood Sports. Have you seen it? 087-122-3333. And do you agree with Aideen's point of view? I know there's probably a number of clubs out there that possibly don't. We'd love to hear from you. 087-122-3333. You're listening to The Wider View on Northern Sound.